हाय वेलकम टू अनदर ट्यूटोरियल्स. मैं हूँ डॉक्टर वान्या श्रीवास्तव और मैं आपको पढ़ाने जा रही हूँ बायोलॉजी का सबसे बेसिक टॉपिक सेल. सेल द यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ. नाउ डेफिनेशन, व्हाट इज द सेल? वी हैव सीन अ नंबर ऑफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स अराउंड अस, ह्यूमन बीइंग्स, प्लांट्स, डॉग्स एंड सो मेनी एनिमल्स. नाउ ऑल दीज एनिमल्स आर कंपोज्ड ऑफ सेल्स. The cell, the definition of the cell is the smallest structural and functional unit of all living organisms. All living organisms are composed of cells, depending upon which they can be either classified as unicellular or multicellular. The unicellular organisms are simple organisms. They are composed of only single cell which is free living. The basic example of unicellular organism is bacteria, right? Now, multicellular organisms, we all human beings are included in the multicellular organisms. These are composed of numerous cells. Examples are sponges, mammals, algae and fungi. These multicellular organisms have a very complex structure. Cells are first, cells first form tissues, then tissues comprise of organs, then organs make up the organ systems. So now before we go into the detail of the structure and function of the cell, we'll first describe you the brief history. The term cytology was coined by Hertwig in 1892. This is a very important point and this is asked in Neet questions also. Cell was discovered by Robert Hooke, who examined dead plant cells. Later, Anthony van Leeuwenhoek constructed simple microscope which could magnify objects up to about 300 times. He microscopically examined pond water and discovered a variety of microorganisms like protozoa, bacteria, and yeast cells. He discovered several types of living cells. However, he could not explain how new cells are formed. That is, he could not explain how the cell division took place and how new cells are formed from the pre-existing cells. Later, Robert Brown studied a number of tissues and discovered a central spherical structure in the living cells, which he called as nucleus. Now we come to cell theory. This is very important. M.J. Schleiden, who was a German botanist, he microscopically examined plant structure, and soon after, Theodor Schön, a German zoologist, examined animal tissues. And they both hypothesized that bodies of plants and animals are composed of cells and their products. Now, as we have previously studied that M.J. Schleiden and Theodor Schön jointly formulated cell theory, the cell theory. The Dolph Welcher first explained that cells divide and the new cells are formed from pre-existing cells. That is, he explained the process of cell division which could not be explained by Schleiden and Schön. Now, the modern cell theory states that all living organisms are composed of cells and all cells arise from pre-existing cells. Now, cell, an overview. The cell is made up of a living substance called protoplasm. The cell has an outer membrane as the delimiting structure. Inside each cell is a dense spherical membrane-bound structure which is called as nucleus. The nucleus contains chromosome which contains the genetic material called DNA. DNA helps in the cell division. Now, DNA transmits the hereditary characteristics from parents to offspring. This forms the basis of life. Hence, each cell duplicates its genetic material, which is the DNA, right? And this DNA divides into daughter cells, which are exact replica or copies of the parent cell. This process is known as cell division. Later we will study the types of cell division which are mitosis and meiosis. Now before going into study the types of cells. There are basically two types of cells, prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. The prokaryotic cells are primitive type of cells. They lack the membrane bound nucleus. The eukaryotic cells are more complex than the prokaryotic cells and they contain the membrane bound nucleus. This is the major difference between the prokaryotic and both prokaryotic and the eukaryotic cells contain a semi-fluid matrix called as cytoplasm. Cytoplasm fills the cell, that is, it occupies the volume of the cell and it is the main arena of all the cellular activities. It contains various enzymes. Now, besides nucleus, eukaryotic cells contain other membrane bound organelles also, which include endoplasmic reticulum, the Golgi complex, lysosomes, mitochondria, microbodies and vacuoles. The vacuoles are present in plant cells. Now these are absent in the these membrane bound organelles are absent in the prokaryotic cells. Now ribosomes are non-membrane bound. These ribosomes, which are non-membrane bound structures, these are present in both the prokaryotic as well as the eukaryotic cells. These are present in the cytoplasm as well as in the two organelles also, that is the chloroplast. Chloroplast is present in plant cell and the two organelles, the mitochondria and the rough endoplasmic reticulum, which are present in animal cells, right? Now, animal cells contain another membrane bound organelle, which is the centriole. Centriole is present around the nucleus and it helps in cell division. Mycoplasma is the smallest cell, which is 0.3 micrometer in length, and the egg of the ostrich is the largest cell. सो आपने हमारा पहला वीडियो जो कि सेल मेन सेल पे था वो आपने देखा. अब हमारा नेक्स्ट वीडियो जो होगा वो प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल के डिटेल के बारे में होगा. अगर हमारा वीडियो आपको अच्छा लगा तो प्लीज़ हमारे वीडियो को लाइक करिए और चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें. ठीक है, यूकैरियोटिक सेल्स.